Hey guys, this is version 2 of my GoPro self-leveling mount. I'm going to give you a quick overview of it and then compare it to the first version real quick, and then we'll get right into the build. The purpose of these self-leveling mounts is that they will keep the camera pointed at the horizon when the mounting base changes angle. I'll show you a little demonstration footage real quick here just to show you what I'm talking about. This is version 2 of the mount that I just finished. Here's the first version, and they both have some positive and negative aspects. Version 1 has a bearing in here, so it keeps the camera pointed at the horizon by balancing it. The downsides are that it's hard to balance this, and when you do, it's only balanced for one case. You know, if you're changing cases from waterproof to the frame, that may come into play. It's possibly a little bit more fragile than the second version. The positive is that it can rotate 360 degrees if that comes into play for your application. And it can be blown by wind, which is a negative. So definitely think about that. The second version, there's no balancing involved. You can easily switch from case to case because you don't have to balance it. It could be slightly stronger. That's kind of one reason I built it. It's not susceptible to wind, but the downside is that it only pivots about 180 degrees. So most applications, that would be enough, but if you need to do over 180 degrees, you might want to build this first version. But I'll put a link to the build up here. Okay, let's start showing you how to build this. The key to the whole self-leveling mount is this miniature rotary damper. This is a dual direction rotary damper built by Ace Controls. I got it from McMaster-Carr. It's about $11 for this tiny little thing, amazingly. But that's the only place that I could find these. It's pretty tiny, but that's the heart of the whole system. The part number from McMaster-Carr is 6597K8, and I'll put a link in the description. So this is the part that's the key. It resists the torque and only lets it spin smoothly. So that is the key to the whole thing. The frame is pretty rudimentary here. It's made out of 1/8 inch thick aluminum, and it's 1¼ inches wide. This is roughly 4.5 long, but you might want to alter that for your situation. The ears on here, I was worried, are kind of flimsy, so I built this mount to sandwich it between two pieces of aluminum. So you can see this slides through like this, and then that bolts together and sandwiches it. Okay, so I've got this bolted together. That just sandwiches the rotary damper in there, just some small bolts. I did want to point out that it's important to get this specific damper. If you get one smaller or larger, the torque rating will be different, and the camera either won't be able to swing because the torque is too high, or it'll just be too small and be floppy and fragile. Okay, so I've got it mounted in there. I wanted to make this as simple as possible, so I just took a long GoPro arm, and it just kind of slides on the shaft. The shaft is keyed on one side, so that keeps the arm from spinning on the shaft. So that's the basic motion of the mount. It just a smooth arc. You can see I had to remove some material down here so that it would clear this nut. And so you just put it on, and then I've got a bolt and a nut, and you just tighten it up, and that keeps it on there. Okay, now I've got it bolted on there. You can see it's still not real secure on there. So I wanted to try to make this a bulletproof mount, so I bent up a piece of sheet metal, and it just through bolts with some long screws all the way through it. And that just keeps them out from flexing out and coming off the shaft. I thought about making something that could securely clamp onto the shaft, but I wanted to make this something that other people could build easily, so that's why I chose to go this direction. So this just threads in here and threads through. So I've got the piece of sheet metal mounted on there, just real rudimentary, as you can tell. Just through bolted and then snug some nuts up there, and that just keeps the arm from coming off, and it doesn't really provide any friction, so it still pivots real easily. Obviously the GoPro camera cases just slide on like normal, and you can see it doesn't have the camera in there, but it's still doing its function. I mount to a lot of metal objects, so I use magnet bases. You can get these at Harbor Freight or Hobby Lobby, and just through bolt them like that. And here I've got it back together with the magnets mounted. You need these spacers. These are just nuts over the bolts, but you need the spacers so that the camera, when it's mounted on here, the side of the camera will clear whatever object you're mounting it to. So I'm mounting to a lot of metal stuff, like I said, but you might want to mount this to different objects. You could put U-clamps on here, or you know, just mount it to a lot of different things. So use your imagination, and you know, this doesn't look that great. The way I fabricate these mounts is I start with an idea, and I just kind of go out in the shop and just mess around. I don't have a lot of high-end tools or anything, so that's why it's not machined perfectly. But that's how the first versions of these start out for me. But anyway, I hope that helps. Thanks for watching, and make sure and let me know if you have questions on this. I'd be glad to help.